places. Run a flower shop on Skid Row.
I'm sorry.
Seymour, what is going on back there?
Very little, Mr. Mushnick.
Audrey, you ought to go back there and see what he's... Audrey, where did you get that shiner?
Shiner?
That greasy boyfriend of yours. He's been beating up on you again? Look, I know it's none of my business, but I'm beginning to think he's maybe not such a nice boy.
You don't meet nice boys when you live in Skid Row, Mr. Mushnick.
I got these plants he potted for you, Mr. Mush. Oh!
Seymour, look what you've done to the inventory!
Don't yell at Seymour, Mr. Mushnick.
Hi, Audrey. You look radiant today. Is that new eye makeup?
I'll clean this up before any of
this. I got it.
Well, I'll give you plenty of time. Look, God wouldn't exist as I got. Misfit employees, bums on the sidewalk, business is lousy. My life is a living hell! You, urchins, off of the stoop! It ain't bad enough I got the winos permanently decorating the storefront. What, I need two worthless ragamuffins to complete the picture?
Oh, we ain't bothering nobody, are we, Crystal?
No, we're not, Ronette.
You ought to be in school!
We're on the split shift.
Right, we went to school till fifth grade, then we split.
So how do you intend to better yourselves?
Better ourselves? Mister, what are you from Skid Row? Ain't no such thing.
Alarm goes off at 7 and you start.
Cater to a million fours. You disinfect her also on the bathroom floor. and poor. I keep asking God what I'm for, and he tells me, gee, I'm not sure. Sweep that floor, kiddo. I started life as an orphan, a child of the streets, here on Skid Row. He took me and gave me shelter, a bed, crust of bread, and a job. Treats me like dirt, calls me a slob, which I am. So I live
downtown.
That's your home address, you live
downtown.
When your life's a mess, you live
downtown.
Where depression's just status quo.
Down on Skid Row.
Someone show me a way to get out of here, 'cause I constantly pray I'll get out of here. Please won't somebody say I'll get out of here. Someone give me my shot or I'll rot here.
Downtown,
show me how and I will all get out of here.
Downtown,
I'll start climbing up the hill and get out of here.
Downtown,
someone tell me I still can get out of here.
Sure.
Someone tell Lady Luck that I'm stuck here.
Downtown,
she and you would be well to get out of here.
Downtown,
been a garden.
Much as a firm. I guess this is it. Don't bother coming in, Toronto.
You don't mean...
You can't mean...
What? What don't I mean? I mean I'm closed. Forget it. Kaput.
You can't...
Kaput! I'm closing this god a customer forsaken place.
Mr. Mushnick, forgive me for saying so, but has it ever occurred to you that maybe what this firm needs is to move in a new direction?
What Seymour's trying to say, Mr. Mushnick, well, we talked about it, we both agreed. Seymour, why don't you run it back and bring out that strange and interesting play you've been working on? You see, Mr. Mushnick, some of those strange and interesting plants Seymour's been tinkering around with are really unusual. And we're both thinking that maybe some of those exotic plants, promptly displayed and advertised, would attract business.
I'm afraid it isn't feeling very well today.
Well, now isn't that bizarre?
At least! What kind of weirdo plant is that, Seymour?
I don't know. It looks like some kind of flytrap, but I haven't been able to identify it in any of my books. So I gave it my own name. I call it an Audrey 2.
After me?
I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, if you put a strange and interesting plant like this here in the window, maybe...
Maybe what? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting...
Excuse me. I couldn't help noticing that strange and interesting plant in the window. What is it?
It's an Audrey 2.
I've never seen anything like it before.
No one has.
Where'd you get it?
Well, do you remember that total eclipse of the sun a couple of weeks ago?
Da-doo.
I was walking in the wholesale flower district that day.
Shoo, da-doo.
And I passed by this place where this old Chinese man,
Shang, da-doo.
He sometimes sells me weird and exotic cuttings.
Snip, da-doo.
Because he knows, you see, strange plants are my hobby.
Da-da-da-da-da-doo.
He didn't have anything unusual there that day.
No, da-doo.
And I was about to, you know, walk on by.
Good for you.
When suddenly, and without warning, there was this total eclipse of the sun. It got very dark, and then there was a strange humming sound like something from another world. And when the light came back on, this weird plant was just sitting there.
Oopsie.
Just stuck in, you know, among the zinnias.
Audrey too.
I could have sworn it hadn't been there before, but the old Chinese man sold it to me anyway. For $1.95.
Well, that's an interesting story, and a fascinating plant. Oh, I almost forgot. I might as well take $50 worth of roses while I'm here.
$50?
$50?
$50?
$50? Yes, sir, right away, sir.
Can you break 100?
100? 100. No, I'm afraid we can't.
Guess I'll just have to take twice as many then, won't I?
Twice as many?
Twice as many?
Twice as many?
$100 worth? Yes, sir, right away, sir. Archie, my darling, kindly fetch this gentleman $100 worth of our very fine American Red Beauty roses.
Thank you. Yes, sir, that is one strange and interesting plant.
Put it back in the window! What do you call it?
An Audrey 2.
Put that Audrey 2 back in the window where the passerbys can see. My God, I never believe it. My children, I'm taking this all to dinner.
Oh, I'd love to, Mrs. Mushnick, but I've got a date.
With the same no good, Nick? Audrey, you don't need a date with him. You need major medical. He ain't a good clean kind of boy.
He's a professional?
What kind of professional drives a motorcycle and wears a black leather jacket?
He's a rebel. But he makes good money, and besides, he's the only fellow I've got. Enjoy dinner. Good night, Seymour.
Good night.
Poor girl.
Are we still going to dinner?
You're not going anywhere, Crabborn. You're staying right here and taking care of that sick plant. How become it's fainting all the time?
I told you, it just wilts like this. The Audrey 2 is not a healthy girl.
Strictly between us, neither is the Audrey 1.
If only I knew what kind of plant it was, what genus. But it's nowhere in the books.
Well, my advice to you, Crabborn, is to figure it out in facts. Look at what that little exotic beauty did for business.
I know.
So work, Seymour, and nurse that plant back to health. I'm counting on you.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So fix! Good night.
Mr. Mushnick and Audrey, they just met you, but I've been going through this with you for weeks. Grow and wilt, spit and flap. Are you sick little plant or just plain stubborn? What is it you want? What is it you need?
I've given you sunshine. I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing but heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly. I'm down on my knees. Oh, please, grow for me. I've given you plant food and water to sip. I've given you potash. You've given me sip. Oh, God, how I missed you. Oh, pot, how you tease. Now, please, grow for me. I've given you southern exposure to get you to thrive. I've pinched you back hard like I'm supposed to. You're barely alive. I've tried you at levels of moisture from desert to mud. I've given you garlic and mineral supplements. What do you want from me? Blood?
Ow! Damn roses. Damn thorns. Clumsy me. Hey, Tui, look what I did. Hey, you opened up. I wonder what made you do that. I think I know what made you do that. Well, I guess a few drops couldn't hurt, as long as you don't make a habit out of it or anything.
I've given you sunlight. I've given you rain. Looks like you're not happy. Let's say open a vein. I'll give you a few drops if that'll appease. Now please, oh please,
grow for me.
And thus we conclude our interview with Seymour Crowborn, the young botanical... Do you mind if I call you a genius?
Gosh, no.
The genius who has developed a new breed of plant life hitherto unknown on this planet. Oh, just one last question, Mr. Krellborn. Do you feed it anything special?
Special? It's a secret formula, but it's not hard to come by.
I see. Well, thanks for dropping by.
I'd like to remind our listeners that the Audrey 2 is on display exclusively at Bush 6
Radio Station WSKID.
The address! It's still great advertising. I can't believe it, it couldn't be happening. Pinch me, girl, it couldn't be happening. All of a sudden, success coming out of the blue. I put a sign up right in the front window, an advertisement right in the front window. Stop in and see the amazing new plant, Audrey 2. And the really remarkable thing is that people, they do. Seymour, that spark of a clutch finally did something right. Audrey 2 drives them nuts. A blessing this wonderful plant should exist. She raising the fuck for me hand over fist.
Well, how'd I do?
He was great, Seymour. You sound expected in the Wolfman.
But you didn't mention the address of the shop. How many times have I told you?
I'm sorry, I got nervous. Where's Audrey? She said she'd be here.
Oh, forget about Audrey. I've got 3 radio interviews lined up for you, and a Skid Row Herald Examiner wants a picture.
Oh, a picture?
Ha! If I had a mother, she'd be so happy.
You're an overnight sensation, Seymour. Who would have believed it?
One day he pushed a broom, nothing in his nose but boom and doom. Then he lit a fuse and give him room. Then the city washed up by the blow. Explosion made the boom. Don't it go to show, you never know.
Seymour was in a funk. He was number 0, who'd have thunk? He'd become a hero, just a punk.
I just cut my hand and in a snap, something out of Edgar Allan Poe has happened.
I tried to be on time, but...
Don't tell me. You got tied up?
No. Just handcuffed. A little.
Girl, I don't know who this mess is hanging out with, but he is hazardous to your health.
That's for sure. But I can't leave him.
And why not?
He'd get angry. He does this when he likes me. Imagine what he'd ever do if he got mad.
So dump the chump. Get another guy and let him protect you. And we got one all picked out for you. A little botanical genius. And she ain't talking about George Washington Carver.
Seymour!
Bingo!
Oh, we're just friends. I could never be Seymour's girl. I've got a past.
And who among us has not?
I don't even deserve a sweet, considerate, suddenly successful guy like Seymour.
Mm-mm-mm. This child suffers from low self-image. She have a point. She have a problem.
I know Seymour is the greatest. But I'm dating a semi-sadist. So
I've got a black eye and my arm's in a cast. So that Seymour's a cutie. Well, if not, he's got inner beauty. So I dream of a place where we could be together at last.
What kind of place is that, honey? An emergency room?
Oh, no, no, it's just a daydream of mine. A little development I dream of, just off the interstate. Not fancy like Levy Town. Just a little street in a little suburb. Far, far from urban Skid Row. In the sweetest, greenest place where everybody has the same little lawn out front. The same little flagstone patio out back. But all the houses are so neat and pretty. Because they all look just alike. Oh, I dream about it all the time. Just me and the toaster. And a sweet little guy, like Seymour. A matchbox of our own. A fence of real chain link. A grill out on the patio. Disposal in the sea. A washer and a dryer. And an iron. Tract house that we share, somewhere that's green. He rakes up, trims the grass. He loves to mow and weed. I cook like Betty Crocker, and I look like Don Reed. His plastic home of furniture.
First spiffing up and grooming, cause customers are flocking and business has been booming. We need refrigeration in our new improved display, so we're closed for renovation today.
Yes indeed, this is the shop you heard about on Channel 5 News. Yes, the Altitude's on display exclusively here.
We're closed for decoration, cause fortune has been smiling. So now we're due for painting, new plumbing and retiling. We'll make this ship-shaped showplace of our little shop, and then tomorrow we'll be open again.
Aren't you finished yet?
I'm trying my best, but all these band-aids make it kinda hard.
You're getting hurt so much lately.
I know. Seems like every time I pick up a pruning shears, I slip.
We're closed for renovation, for swabbing down and brooming, cause business has been thriving since Altitude's been blooming. The phone that has been ringing with the customers today. Another bunch of peonies.
Another dozen daisies, please.
Geraniums and amonies.
Forget-me-nots in Florida, please.
With gratis home deliveries, I'm paid in full to CODs. We're closed for renovation.
celebration today. Seymour! Did you send out that order for Mrs. Shiva?
Mrs. Shiva?
Mrs. Shiva!
Mrs. Shiva! I forgot!
You forgot? How could you forget an order like that? The Shivers are our most important funereal account and they're dropping off like flies. I'm telling you, Krebhorn, if we lose their business because of this, you are finished!
You know, I think Mr. Mushnik's too hard on you sometimes.
Oh, I don't mind. After all, I owe him everything. He took me at the Skid Row Home for Boys when I was just a little tyke. Gave me a warm place to sleep, under the counter. Nice things to eat, like meatloaf and water. Floors to sweep and toilets to clean and every other Sunday off.
You know, I think you've got to raise your expectations, Seymour, now that we're getting successful and all. I mean, why don't you start with some new clothes? No offense! But with what all the interviews and photo sessions, a big important experimental botanist has to look the part.
I'm a very bad shopper, Audrey. I don't have good taste like you.
Well, I could help you pick things out.
You could?
Sure.
You'd go shopping with me?
Sure.
You'd be seen with me in a public place? Like a department store?
Sure.
Tonight?
I can't tonight, but I'd love to go with you another time.
Sure. Sure, I'll pencil you in.
I bet you get a lot of dates now, huh?
Not dates exactly, but a lot of garden clubs have been calling, asking me to give lectures.
Gee.
Imagine me giving lectures. I never finished grade school.
That doesn't matter. You have life experience.
Some experience. I don't even know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Me neither.
Or eat a fancy dinner at Howard Johnson's.
Me neither.
Or ride a motorcycle.
Oh, it's no big deal. And besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
Extremely dangerous. Oh, I better go fix my face. My dad will be here any minute now.
Hey there, ladies. Which way to 1313 Skid Row?
I'm afraid that information will cost you a dollar.
Hey, no problem. Here you go.
It's right over there, but if like the thousands of others flocking out to see Audrey too, you better come back tomorrow, man. The shop's closed today.
Ooh, it took a dollar!
I'm not here to buy posies, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date? You want me to talk about the girl with the black eye?
And several other medical problems?
As a matter of fact.
That's him! That's you! You did it to Audrey!
Ladies, ladies. Please, a friendly truce. Percent. You want some nitrous oxide?
Why do you get lost with Talus Springs? The last thing Audrey needs is more of your kind.
My kind is a very nice kind, ladies. I'm not a monster.
What else would you call it?
I would call it... I would call it an occupation of hazard.
Say what?
You see, ladies, my line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering. Woo! This stuff is great! Allow me to explain. When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did. Like shooting puppies with a BB gun. I poisoned guppies, and when I was done, I found a pussy, got it bashed in its head. That's what my mama said.
What did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay. You'll be a dentist. You have the talent for causing big pain. Son, be a dentist. People will pay you to be
inhumane.
Your temperament's wrong for the priesthood, and teaching will suit you so less. Son, be a dentist. You'll be a success.
Serious girl, the leader of the flat. Watch him suck up that gas. Oh my God. He's a dentist and will never be any good. Who wants their teeth done by the marketing side? Oh, that hurts. I'm not numb.
Shut up! Open wide! Here I come! I'm your dentist!
Administration!
And I enjoy the career that I think
you love it!
I am your dentist!
Something
and I get up on the pain I play!
Really love it!
When I my patience distress.
Distress?
Somewhere in heaven above me, I know that my mama's proud of me. Guys, I'm a dancer. Ain't the success. Say ah.
Ah.
Say ah. Hey, how's it going?
Fine, thank you, but the shop's closed.
I'm not here to shop, I'm here to... Hey! That must be that new plant they're talking about on the news. What you call it?
An Audrey 2.
An Audrey 2. Cute name, catchy, nice plant, big!
Thanks, I raised it myself. Now, if you don't
they
mind...
They say some sort of new species or something.
That's what they tell me, but you'll have to leave now, we...
It's okay, Seymour. This is my boyfriend. Seymour, Orange Cavello, DDS.
I'll tell you something, kid. You said you raised this thing, right?
Right.
Well, if I were you, I sure as hell wouldn't keep it in an underbaron skid row dump like this. This avocado here could be your ticket to the stars. You could take it to any florist shop in town and name your prize. Hell, someone to make you a goddamn partner to get their hands on this.
I don't care. I'm happy here.
Seymour's very loyal.
Somebody talking to you?
Oh, excuse me.
Excuse me what?
Excuse me, doctor. Excuse me, doctor.
That's better. I'm telling you, kid, this thing's a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of this dump and take the plant with you.
What?
Mushnick Skid Row Florist?
It's like a joke.
You hear me talking?
I hear you.
He hears him.
Shouldn't we be leaving now? I'm sorry.
I'm sorry what?
I'm sorry, doctor.
You gotta train him. Hey, son. Well, my bike's outside and double parked. But you think about it, Scott. I mean it. You think about it.
Sure. I'll think about it.
He'll think about it.
You do that. Okay, Audrey, you got the handcuffs.
Yeah.
Then let's go.
He'll think about it, he'll think about it.
I don't like that guy, Mr. Mushnick, and you should hear the way he talks to Audrey.
God and him will know the kid just said he'd mull it over.
No wonder she looks so unhealthy, it's enough to make you sick.
If he left me, if Seymour left me, why didn't I be right back where I started, which was broken, starving.
Sweet and good and beautiful as she is, she deserves a prince, not a sadistic creep like him.
Close to bankrupt.
What a louse.
Be set, befuddled, and bereft. That's what I'd be if Seymour left.
He's disgraced to the dental profession.
Seymour!
Sir?
Seymour! How would you like to be my son? How would you like to be my own adopted boy? I never liked them much before. I count the cash that's in the drawer. I've got no choice. I must do poor things.
What for?
Seymour, I want to be your dad. I want to see you climbing up my family tree. I used to think you left a stench, but now I see that you're a myth. So I'm proposing to be my son. Mushnick and son. Sounds great. Three words with the ring of fate. So say you'll incorporate with me. A florist dream come true. Mushnick and his boy chick, you. What business will do for FTD? How about it, Seymour, be my son? Just say the word, I'll have my lawyer on the phone.
Now, Mr. Mushnick, don't be rash. You always said that I was trash.
Oh, I was joking! I used the physical expression of my pride. Of the sweet paternal miss she goes, I held myself inside.
Gee.
So?
Well? I...
You? Go ahead and say it, Seymour. Tell me that you will.
Gee, I'd really like to, but...
I'll hold my breath until...
Grow more.
Okay, you win, I'll be your son.
Hurry, I win, he'll be my son.
Drop the papers that I've touched, I really am. And when you reach age 83, I'll let you come move in with me.
You swear?
I promise.
What a son.
Mushnick and son, not that. Officially, I'm your pet.
Consider the matter closed and done. Now to the world, let's stick our senior and junior stick. Through thin and through thick, through sloppy and slick.
So come kiss me quick.
Please don't make me sick, Mushnick.
Sudden changes surround me. Lady Luck came and found me. Thanks a million for making the magic you do. Thanks to you, sweet Petunia, Mushnick's taken a junior. And someday when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you. Who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side these past 2 weeks? So what if I had a few dizzy spells? A little lightheadedness? It's been worth it, old pal. Well, Tui, I'm a little hungry. I'm gonna run down to Schmendrick's and get a bite to eat. I'll see ya. Oh boy, here we go again. Look, I haven't got much left. Just give me a few more days to heal, okay? Then we can start again on the left hand and...
Feed me.
I beg your pardon?
Feed me.
Joey, you talked! You opened up your trap, your thing, and you said...
Feed me, Clubhorn, feed me now.
I can't.
I'm starving.
Oh, boy. Look, maybe I can squeeze a little out of this one,
I need some food.
I know, but you can't get blood
more,
from
more.
What do you want me to do, slit my wrists? Look, how about I run down to the corner and pick you up some nice chopped sirloin?
Must be blood.
Joey, that's disgusting.
Must be fresh.
I don't want to hear this.
Feed me.
Does it have to be human?
Feed me.
Does it have to be mine?
Feed me.
Where am I supposed to get it?
Feed me all night long. That's right, boy. You can do it. Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. 'Cause if you feed me, Seymour, I can grow up big and strong.
You eat blood, Audrey, too. Let's face it. How am I supposed to keep on feeding you? Kill people?
I'll make it worth your while.
What?
You think this is all a coincidence, baby? The sudden success around here? Your adoption papers?
Look, you're a plant and an inanimate object!
Does this look inanimate to you, punk? If I can talk and I can move, who's to say I can't do anything I want?
Like what?
Like deliver, pal. Like see you get everything. Your secret, breezy, heart desires. How'd you like a Cadillac car? Or we catch shot on Jack Bar? How about a date with Helen? Oh, you're gonna get it.
No thanks, Joey. Kind of you to offer, but...
How'd you like to be a big wheel? Dining out for every meal. I'm the plant that can make it over here. You're gonna get it. I'm your genie. I'm your friend. I'm your willing slave. Take a chance. Just feed me air. You know the kind of eat, the kind of run out treats, the kind of sticky, licky sweets I crave. Come on, Seymour, don't be a putz. Trust me and your life will show the rival keep touch. Show a little initiative, work up the guts, and you'll get it.
I don't know. I have so, Sony Strong.
fancy it meant to be. Come on, kid, what'll it be? Money? Girls? What particular girl? How about that Audrey? Think it over. There must be someone you can 86. Real quiet-like, give me some lunch. How's about a room at the Ritz? Wrapped in velvet, collar and glitz. A little nookie for the criminal sits and you'll get it.
Gee, I'd like a Harlem machine. Cruising around the guy with James Dean. Making all the guys out of gonna just dream.
So don't get it. If you wanna be profound, you really gotta justify. Take a breath and look around. A lot of folks deserve to die.
Wait a minute. That's not a very nice thing to say.
But it's true, isn't it?
No, I don't know anybody who deserves to get chopped up in federal hungry plant.
Sure you do.
Stupid boy!
Quit
for the freaking scatterbrain! Now get that hand in there, pick up your goddamn sweater, you
yes,
bitchy gal!
Anyway, doctor.
Come on, move it, you little slut! How'd you like that stupid Dave? Forget your freaking sweater. Christ, if your stupid head was screwed on!
Oren! That hurt!
Come on!
Move it!
If you want a rationale, it'll be hard to see. Stop and take it all the pound. The guy sure looks like that food to me. The guy sure looks like that food to me.
He's so nasty, treating her up,
smacking her around and always talking so tough.
You need blood, he's got more than enough.
I need blood, he's got more than enough.
You need blood, he's got more than enough.
So go get it.
Do you have an appointment?
We met yesterday. Seymour Krelborn.
Oh, sure, the guy with the plan.
Right.
And the band-aid.
Right.
And the gun.
Right.
So why are you pointing a gun at me, Seymour?
Hey,
aren't you a little bit too nervous about seeing a little old dentist?
No, I'm not nervous,
It's only gonna hurt a little.
No, you don't understand. I don't want my teeth examined.
Of course you want your teeth examined. Say ah.
No!
Say ah! Ew. Your mouth is a mess, kid. You got cavities. You got plaque. You're impacted. You're obsessed.
I am?
You need a complete oral examination. What's up with that wisdom tooth?
No!
Well, just rip that little bugger out of there. What do you say?
I gotta go!
There's always time for dental hygiene, Seymour. Have you seen the results of a neglected mouth? Look. This could happen to you.
It could?
Unless you take immediate action. Let's get started.
Wait! Aren't you gonna give me Novocaine?
What for? Dose of senses.
But it'll hurt.
Only till you pass out.
What's that?
That's the drill, Seymour.
It's rusty.
It's antique. They don't make instruments like this anymore. Sturdy. Heavy. Dull. This is gonna be a challenge. This is gonna be a pleasure. I'm gonna want some gas for this one. Gas.
Gas?
Nitrous oxide.
Thank God! I thought you weren't gonna use any.
Oh, Seymour, the gas isn't for you. It's for me. You see, I find it that a little gecko gas before we begin. Increases my pleasure enormously. In fact, I'm gonna use my special gas mask. Just relax, Seymour. I'll be with you in just a moment. Now,
Do it now! While he's gassing himself to a palpable stupor, the time is ideal and the moment is super to ready and fire and blow the sick bastard away!
Yeah.
Now! Do it now! With a flicker of pressure right here on the trigger, then Audrey won't have to put up with this pig for another day! Now! For the girl! Now! For the plant! Now! Yes, I will! But I can't.
Oh, I see my eye in flying now. Oh, the things we're gonna do to your mouth. Well, I think I've had enough of this stuff now. I'll just take the mask off and... Hey, Seymour, guess what?
What?
The mask. It's stuck.
What?
The mask. It's stuck. I can't get it off. Jesus Christ. I'm gonna miss you, idiot. Come on, Seymour, give me a hand.
Well?
Well? He says, well? Seymour, I don't think you understand. Don't be fooled if I should giggle like a sappy happy dump. It's just the gas. It's got me high. But don't let the fact deceive you any moment I could die. Though I giggle and I jodle, bear in mind I'm not immortal. Why this whole thing strikes me funny, I don't know. Cause it really is the right way to go.
What we have here is an ethical dilemma. Must they help him get the mask? Maybe he doesn't have a prayer. To the gun must never fire. But the way events should fire, I can finish him with some laissez-faire. What we have here is a tricky moral clock. Should I help him get the mask? Let him go like a pair. Could shot him when I tried. The face on my side. A good thought that got my staying in the chair.
Don't be fooled if I should chuckle like a hyena's in a zoo. It does the gas. It turns me on. But don't let that fact deceive you anymore. I'll be gone. Oh, my vital sense is failing because the young lad of me daily makes it difficult as that to catch my breath. Are you dumb or out of hearing? Or relieve, my end is nearing. Are you satisfied? At last, myself too.
Thank you.
wrote Save the Children.
Let's get
home.
I'll just
work 25, 50, 50. How do you live? Where do you live?
Where do you live?
Look,
Wish Against Guns gave us flying for us. Now you are saying flowers for a prom corsage.
Flowers for an entourage.
Flowers for the funeral home.
Leaving cooks and Andrews, Roman Catholic Church at 9th and Vine.
$40 hold the line.
Call back in the morning.
Fine.
We'll be there in the morning.
Can you hold, please? The Rose Bowl. Before the Rose Bowl. You know that big inflated estimate we wrote. For the Rose Bowl. Every single float. We can't keep the tournament waiting.
Mushnick and Son.
Can you hold?
Please hold.
Can you hold?
It's just as the plan foretold.
Just a minute.
It's business like who had ever guessed.
Mushnick and Son.
That was me.
Please
that
wait.
Was me.
The business
on
is
Channel 3.
So why am I feeling so depressed?
I guess you'd make it. Game, Mushnick and Son, Skid Row's favorite floors.
7,000 Bonnier's carnations or the yellow roses.
Please, I've only got few ears allergic to chrysanthemum.
Hollyoaks or Hardier, which one would your wife prefer?
Were you waiting long? I'm sorry, sir. 1 minute and I'll be there for you.
Seymour, that reporter.
Sir, I thought we finished yesterday.
Wants another interview, sent to bring the plant with you.
Audrey, it's the right account.
Sir, that's the right amount.
Daisy's only come in white.
Sir, I'm too worn out to fight.
Sorry, those are out of stock.
Seymour, look, it's 6 o'clock.
Call back in the morning, will you?
Call back in the morning, won't you?
Call back in the morning, can you?
Call back in the morning, thank you.
Call back in the morning.
What a day. If you mind locking up for me, I'm all in.
1 minute, Audrey. I want to show you something.
Can it wait till tomorrow?
It won't take too long. I've been shopping for a new wardrobe like you asked, and... ta-da! What do you think?
Say more.
You don't like it?
I don't know.
I'll take it off. I'll take it back. I'll burn it! Just don't cry, please. Look what I did. I only bought it to impress you. That's all I ever meant to do.
Seymour, I don't know what's been wrong with me lately. I guess I've just been feeling a little under the weather.
It's Oren, isn't it? You've been down in the dumps ever since his murder. Mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? I've never felt so relieved as when they told me he'd vanished. It was a miracle. Not to mention all the money I saved on Epsom salts and Ace bandages.
Then what's the matter?
I guess I feel guilty a little. See, if you met with some terrible accident or foul play, then it's partly my fault, you see. Because secretly, I wished it.
Audrey, don't spend one more minute worrying about that creep. There's a lot of guys who would give anything to go out with you. Nice guys.
I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
That's not true.
You don't know half of it. I live a terrible life.
Audrey, don't...
You know where I met him? In the gutter.
The gutter?
The gutter. It's a nice spot. I worked there on my nights off when we weren't making money or shmoney. I'd wear cheap and tasteless outfits. Not nice ones. Like this. Low and nasty apparel and
Audrey, that's all behind you now. You don't have anything to be ashamed of. You're a very nice person and I always knew you were. Underneath all the bruises and handcuffs, you know what I saw? A girl I respected. I still do.
Lift up your head, wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup. Don't have to pretend. suddenly Seymour is here to provide you with sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Dad, you know he disappeared.
That's right. He did, didn't he? Forgive me, Boychin.
Seymour, what's he doing? What's he talking about?
Why don't you run along like he asked, Audrey? I'll catch up to you later. I'll call if that's okay.
Of course it is. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Mr. Mishnick.
Little red dots all over the floor.
You're acting pretty strange, Pop.
Had a pretty strange afternoon, son. After my lawyer's appointment, I got called down to the police station.
The police?
Yes, and when they did, it seems they made a routine investigation into this motorcycle dentist. And when they did, they found a Mushnick Skid Row florist bag in his office.
What's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour. And then I began to notice the little things around here. Little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch and it stained.
Hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it? Especially when they only remove our garbage once a month.
What does that have to do with... Where are you going?
You want something removed in a hurry, it's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform!
He's got your number now.
I saw it last week and I didn't think twice.
He knows just what you've done.
And the little red dot seemed innocent enough.
You've got no place to hide.
And then I catch kissing the dentist's girlfriend.
You've got nowhere to run.
And then it begins to look like a motive.
He knows your life of crime.
Once he's out the way, you move in, right?
I think it's supper time.
I'm innocent!
Then explain this!
picture of a baseball cap?
Your baseball cap, Seymour! They found it in Scavello's office and asked if I can identify it.
Did you?
No! They don't suspect you at all, Seymour. But what they don't know about is the dots, the girlfriend, and the uniform.
I didn't do it!
Then come with me to them and tell me that.
He's got his facts all straight.
If you don't, I have to go tell them myself.
You know he's on your trail.
Just so my conscience will rest easy.
He's gonna turn you in.
Now will you come?
They're gonna put you in jail.
Okay.
He's USDA Brian.
Great, I'll lock up and we'll head over.
For my supper time. Come on, come on. Think about all those offers. Come on, come on. Your future with Audrey. Come on. Come on, ain't no time to get squeamish. Come on, come on. I swear on all my sports. When he's gone, the world will be yours.
Okay, Seymour, let's go.
Don't you want to collect the day's receipts so you can deposit them in the morning?
You put them in the safe, didn't you?
No.
Why not?
I forgot the combination.
Come on, custom dollars. Where is it?
In the plan.
In the plant?
I thought that'd be the safest place. No thief would ever look in there,
money,
right?
It's inside of the plant? So how am I supposed to get it?
Just knock.
Knock? Thank you, girls. Seymour Krelborn, sweetie, honey, baby, pussycat.
Do I know you?
Of course not, but are you gonna be happy when you do? Seymour, sweetheart, dollface, bubble. Hey, Seymour Krelborn, you prince, you. My name is Bernstein, I'm with NBC. I came down here to convince you to do a weekly TV show for me. Seymour Krelborn's got an 8-tip salad. For half an hour on Sundays at 4. TV's first home gardening program. You'll make a mint and our ratings will soar.
They say you shall inherit. You know the book isn't law. It's not a question of merit. It's not demand or supply. They say the meat's gonna get it. And you're a meek little guy.
Come on, Seymour. Your own TV show?
Coast to Coast?
Your name in life?
Your face on screen?
Sign
that contract!
I'm not sure that's such a good idea.
Why, Seymour? You have to sign it.
Why?
This is a contract, Seymour. You can get money from contracts.
Well, you always gotta read the fine print, right? They're always trying to trick you and...
Forget about it, Seymour. Come on, just sign. You can get out of Skid Row. You can get out of this trash dump.
I have unfinished business.
unfinished business.
What do you mean?
Is it Audrey? Do you like Audrey?
Oh, I think he does. Oh, it's okay. Oh, there he is, Miss Lucy. We found him. He's right here.
Oh, my darling, my precious, my sweet, sweet king. So delighted to make your acquaintance. Seymour, sweetness. Seymour, Mevadal. I'd like a word with your lover. I'm sure you know we're the editor's wife. We want your face on the cover of the December 30 issue of Life. Yes, the front of Life magazine. That's an honor we so seldom grant. We'll send someone down, let's say Thursday, for shots of you and your beautiful blonde.
This is a me, Sean Harris. You know the book is a lie. It's not a question of merit. It's not the man, it's a fly. They said the meat's gonna get it. And you're a big little guy. You know the meat's gonna get what's coming to him by and by.
Life magazine? Oh my goodness, Seymour, you're gonna make it straight to the top! How'd you do it, Seymour? Tell us, you gotta tell us.
Hard work, patience, a little luck,
and...
panache.
Seymour. What are you talking about? There has to be more things to do.
Tell us your secret. Come on, Seymour, come on.
Step one, look that way, and wait.
Seymour!
Oh, come on.
Come on, Seymour, why can't you tell us? Why is it such a big secret?
Well, it might change how everyone sees me, I suppose.
What are you talking about? It's not like you kill people. Oh, that's funny, Seymour. There he is, sir. The incredible Seymour Crowborn, owner of the fabulous Audrey 2, America's most amazing and largest unidentified plant.
So this is Seymour Crowborn. We've been trying to reach you, baby. Have your phones been busy? Did you get our telegram?
I don't think so.
Well, it's a good thing I came down in person then. Skip Snip, William Morris Agency, huh? Forget the cable we sent you. It's nice to meet me, the pleasure is yours. Now let my firm represent you. We want to book you on lecturing tours. College campuses, Rotary clubs. The kind of bookings my office can do. You'll show the plant, then talk, answer questions. It's educational, lucrative too.
My future's starting, I've got to let it. Stick with this plant and gee, my bank account will thrive. What am I saying? No way, forget it. It's much too dangerous to keep the plant alive. I take these orders, it means for killing. Who knew success would come with messy, nasty strings? I sign these contracts, that means I'm willing to keep on doing bloody awful evil things. No, no, there's only so far you can bend. No, no, this nightmare must come to an end. No, no, you've got no alternative, Seymour. Avoid the wind, meat you'll be broken and unemployed. It's the only solution, it can't be avoided. The vegetable must be destroyed. But then there's Audrey, lovely Audrey. If life were tawdry and impoverished as before, she might not like me. She may not want me. Without my plant, she might not love me anymore.
Shall inherit.
Where do I sign? Right on the line.
That'll
do fine. This
copy's mine.
Corners go wrong.
Bye bye,
so
long.
You know the meek are gonna get what's coming to them.
You know the meek are gonna get what's coming to them. Bye.
need me.
Lay off, Tui. Can't you see I'm busy?
Tuh, kitty.
What's your language?
Grub!
Give me a break. I gotta finish my speech for the lecture tour. It's all about you. Now give me some peace and quiet, or I'll tell him the truth.
Don't get cute with me. I made you, and I can break you.
Go ahead. Break me. You think it's easy living with the guilt?
Ooh! Cut the crap and bring on the meat.
If only you'd eat meat. If only you'd touch a mouse of thighs, but no. You're so particular.
Come on, Crabbone, feed me. I ain't it since Mushnick.
And that was a week ago.
Look, just hold out one more night, can you? That's all I ask. Life magazine will be here in the morning to take our pictures.
And then you'll find me somebody?
Then you'll never go hungry again. I promise.
Chow time, Crowball!
I can't take it! Stop squalling! You're trying to be crazy! Just shut up, William! For God's sake! Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
You're hysterical! What's the matter with you?
It's the matter with me! Don't you think I know I need food? Don't you think I know I'll die if I don't feed it? Don't you think I'm trying to think of some way, something, someone?
Seymour, I think running this place by yourself is too much for you. When did Mr. Mushnick say he'd be back?
Huh?
You know, in that note you said he left you, where he's going out to sister's house in...
Czechoslovakia, right. He could be gone a very long time. Hey, Audrey, could I ask you something?
Anything.
Well, suppose for just 1 minute there never even been an Audrey 2. That I was just a nothing again, a nobody. Would you still like me?
I'd still love you, Seymour.
It's settled then.
What's settled? A gun!
And bullets! And rat poison, and a machete. Tomorrow morning, right after Life magazine takes our pictures, you know who bites the dust.
Seymour!
Right? They'll snap the photos. We'll be famous. I'll take that TV job, and we'll live a nice, quiet, normal life together. No more night feedings. No more squalling for blood.
What blood? What feedings? Seymour, bullets, knives, rat poison, you're scaring me.
There's nothing to be scared of. We'll go away from here. I'll take you to that little development you always dreamed about. And once we're there, we'll live happily ever after. I promise. Nice little house. Nice little car. And no plants. No plants at all.
Seymour, you're talking so peculiar.
I'll explain everything to you tomorrow. Just go home now, Audrey. Please.
I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything.
Feed me?
Under no circumstances.
Feed me!
I will not, so stop asking!
Feed me!
I can't take much more of this. Look, how about I run down to the corner and pick you up some rare roast beef? Maybe that'll hold you over till Life magazine gets here.
Mm-mm. No way.
Look, it's my final offer. Yes or no?
I suppose it's better than nothing.
Done! Fine! Great! But don't think you're getting dessert.
I couldn't sleep, I took a Somanex, but voices in my head kept saying, go to Seymour, go to Seymour. I drank some tea, but gee, the feeling wasn't gone. Seymour, sweetheart, tell me, darling, what's been going on?
Hey, little lady, hello.
Who said that?
You're looking cute as can be.
Is somebody in there?
You're looking mighty sweet.
Seymour, Seymour!
No, it ain't Seymour, it's me.
Oh my God!
Friendly Audrey too. This plant is talking to you.
I don't believe it.
Believe it, baby, it talks.
Am I dreaming this?
No, and you ain't in Kansas neither.
Some Something's very wrong here.
Relax and go with it, doll. Do me a favor, will you?
A favor?
I need some water in the worst way. Look at my branches. I'm a goner, honey. Come on and give me a drink.
I don't know if I should.
Get it, let it be nice.
You just want water, right?
Should you all drink it straight?
Oh, poor thing, your branches are all dry.
Don't need no glass or no ice.
I'll get the can.
Don't need no twist of lime.
Here you go.
And now it's supper time. Relax, sweetheart, it'll be easier. Join your dentist friend and Mushnik. They're right inside.
No! Audrey! Get off her! Get off her! Audrey, are you all right?
Yes. No.
Audrey, don't die. I need you. Please. Please don't die.
You know, the pledge said the strangest thing just now. That Mr. Mushnik and Orin were already inside.
It's true. I did it. I fed them to it.
And that's what made it so big and strong, and you so famous?
I've done horrible things, but not to you. Never to you.
But Seymour, I want you to.
What?
Seymour, when I die, which should be very shortly, I want you to feed me to the plant so it can bring you all the wonderful things you deserve.
You don't know what you're saying.
But I do, Seymour. Because if I'm in the plant, then I'm part of the plant. So in a way, we'll always be together.
Audrey. Stay with me.
You'll wash my tender leaves. You'll smell my sweet perfume. You'll water me and care for me. You'll watch me bud and bloom. I'm feeling strangely happy now.
He's right in there.
Thanks, sweetheart. Wait for me. Seymour Krellborn? Mr. Krell?
Leave me alone.
Patrick Martin, Licensing and Marketing Division, World Botanical Enterprises. I've got a gilt-edged proposition for you.
I'm not interested.
Let me explain in further detail. It's a very simple licensing deal. We take leaf cuttings, develop little audrey tubes, and send them to florists across the nation. Pretty soon, every household in America will have one. Oh, imagine that, audrey tubes everywhere. I've got a truck waiting outside and some pots. If you don't mind, we'll start taking cuttings right now. Imagine, with the right advertising, this could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops?
Much bigger!
every household in America, thousands of you eating. That's what you had in mind all along, isn't it?
No shit, Sherlock!
We're not talking about one hungry plant here. We're talking about world conflict!
And I want to thank you!
You're a monster! And so am I!
Feed me!
You ain't the only thing I ever loved!
Too bad!
Take that! And that! And that! And that! And that! And that!
Give up, Crowborn!
Never! Here, rat poison. Eat it! Eat it, eat it, eat it!
Give up, small fry!
Maybe you're tough on the outside, but in there, in that pod, I'll hack you to bits! I'll get you from the inside! Open up, open up, open up! Now! Stop!
Mr. Crowborn! Mr. Crowborn? Okay, girls. All you gotta do is cut some of the small leaves and put them in the pots. We've got a truck waiting outside. Open the van, boys! We're ready to start loading.
Look out! Here I come for you! out the harbor is lost. Little shop of terror, watch it drop. Little shop of horror, no, oh, oh, no.
Come on, come on.